So pretty recently we had a period where I was doing a lot of shows about Batman because this happened, and the subject of Robin came up a few times, leading some folks to ask if I could do a show explaining who the different Robins were, since most people have only heard of Dick Grayson and maybe Tim Drake. You know, that's not a bad idea.
Comics are weird!
Firstly, let's talk about Robin for a minute. Given that he's only had a sporadic presence in the live-action movies that have been how a lot of people were introduced to Batman for the last couple decades, he's often thought of as a vestigial part of the franchise, a lame character shoehorned into Batman's universe to make him more appealing to kids. And you know what? It is true that Robin wasn't originally part of the comics. There really was a mythic period where Batman worked totally alone and there was no lame, goofy kid sidekick to be found. And this long-lost golden age of Batman lasted all the way from May 1939 to April of 1940. Yes, 1 year. So, can we put this particular misconception to bed? Love him or hate him, Robin is damn near as constant a part of Batman as Watson is to Sherlock Holmes. The thing is, kid sidekicks were big in comics and the rest of adventure fiction in the 30s and 40s, and I think the reason had less to do with pandering, since kids were already reading these books, and more to do with filling a somewhat unspoken need. You know what was a big problem in that era for kids? Absent fathers. Remember, the Great Depression had decimated the working class, driving a lot of primary breadwinners, aka comic-reading kids' fathers, to abandonment, depression, and even suicide. And then World War II happened, and even more dads got called off to the fight. Kid sidekicks transformed their respective heroes into explicit father figure characters, and I have to wonder if, intentionally or not, Robin led comic-reading kids of the era to adopt Batman and others like him as dad surrogates. Anyway, let's get to the breakdown. Robin number one was Dick Grayson. He's the one everyone's heard of. His parents were murdered circus acrobats, he's adopted by Bruce Wayne, and becomes his partner in crime fighting. In 1964, Robin and the other kid sidekicks got so popular that DC decided to put Robin, Wonder Girl, Kid Flash, Speedy, and Aqualad on a team of their own called the Teen Titans. It wasn't all that popular, but in the 1980s, teenage heroes became the thing to do, and DC revived the concept to much, much greater success. That series, which was the basis for the Teen Titans cartoon show, saw Grayson change his costumed identity to Nightwing, which, for reasons that I do not have time to explain, is actually a reference to a Superman story. A few years ago, he replaced Bruce Wayne as Batman. While Bruce was kinda sorta quasi-dead, I'm reasonably certain he's Nightwing again currently. Number 2, Jason Todd. Okay, this is a little confusing, but Jason Todd was first introduced right around the same time Grayson became Nightwing. DC was still skittish about the big change, so they split the difference by giving Jason literally the same dead circus parents' origin as his predecessor. Fans were more or less okay with him. However, when DC's continuity got rejiggered almost immediately after that by Crisis on Infinite Earths, I explained that in this episode, Jason got a new origin story where he's a tough, cool, rebellious street kid who talks back to Batman and also maybe murders a guy. The fans hated him, and in a 1988 arc called Death in the Family, he's mortally wounded by the Joker during a period wherein the Joker had been named the Iranian ambassador to the United Nations. Yeah. So DC set up a 900 number whereby fans could vote whether Todd would live or die from his injuries. They voted for death. When DC's universe was altered once again in 2006 by the reality-punching outbursts of Superboy Prime, look it up, one of the side effects was Jason Todd rising from the grave. He hooked up with Ra's al Ghul for a while and was even an item with Talia, then rechristened himself the Red Hood in reference to the first alias of the Joker, and proceeded to carry out vigilante justice and mess with Batman's head. A lot of this was revealed in flashbacks, by the way. Then he messed with Dick Grayson's head by dressing up as an evil version of Nightwing. He briefly adopted the mantle of Red Robin, a persona originally belonging to an older Grayson in the alternate future Kingdom Come universe, but then went back to being the Red Hood. Number 3. Tim Drake. A lot of fans actually consider Tim, who was named after Tim Burton as a reference to the then-new Robin-free Batman movie, to be the best Robin ever. He first appeared in 1989, not long after Jason Todd's death. Drake is a big fan of Batman and a natural-born master detective who correctly figured out his hero's secret identity when he was only 9 years old. As a teenager, he actually approaches Batman and offers to become the new Robin because, in his opinion, Batman has been going too crazy ever since Jason Todd died. Tim is actually the first Robin to have a book all to himself, while also founding the superhero team Young Justice and reforming the Teen Titans. During the period where Bruce Wayne was believed dead and Dick Grayson and Damian Wayne had become the new Batman and Robin, Drake took up the Red Robin mantle left dormant by Jason Todd. Robin number 4 and the first canonical female Robin was Stephanie Brown, formerly known as Spoiler and the daughter of a supervillain named Cluemaster. Also, she was Tim Drake's girlfriend. When Tim was ordered to retire as Robin for a time by his parents, she browbeat Batman into letting her be the next Robin, but she wasn't very good at it and he fired her. Now, this is where it got messed up. During the storyline War Games, Stephanie tries to prove herself to Batman by putting one of his shelved start a gang war to wipe out the mob plans into effect, and she winds up getting tortured by the villain Black Mask and actually dies from it. Then, slightly later, it's revealed that Batman's doctor friend Leslie Tompkins had the opportunity to save her life, but chose to let her die because she thought that maybe this would convince teenagers to stop signing up to be Robin. People hated that story, so DC later retconned it so the death was only staged, and not long after that, Stephanie became the new Batgirl. And then the DC Universe got rebooted, turning Barbara Gordon back into Batgirl, and I don't think they've decided what happened to Stephanie yet. And finally, Robin number 5, and current holder of the title, Damian Wayne, the son of Bruce Wayne and Talia al Ghul, whose existence I already explained 2 weeks ago. So, those are your Robins. Pick your brains up off the floor, and we'll reconvene next week. I'm Bob, and that's The Big Picture.